Hi everyone, I'm Luke, and in this video, I've prepared a full Duolingo English test for you. This test that I've prepared is very similar to the real test. You will get all of the different question types, roughly the same amount of times as you will have on the real test, and the time limit you have for each question will be exactly the same. The only difference is that at the end of each question, I will show you the correct answers. This will help show you whether you did well or poorly. Of course, for the speaking and writing questions, your answers might vary. And that's okay. I will still show you my sample answers, and then you can compare yours with mine. But before we do that, if you think this video is helpful, please write yes below in the comments and give this video a like. Okay then, well, let's get to it.
I like either milk or sugar with my coffee, but not both.
Okay, just a quick interruption. I just want to let you know that I do have my own website now. It's called detready.com. Go over to that website to find more resources about the Duolingo English test.
Stance. Stance. Flinged. Flinged. Denial. Denial. Correction. Correction. Terrify. Terrify. Depact. Depact. Agalition. Agalition. Ansus. Ansus. Specimen. Specimen.
There are thousands of robots doing a wide variety of tasks in hospitals. There are thousands of robots doing a wide variety of tasks in hospitals. There are thousands of robots doing a wide variety of tasks in hospitals.
Both my parents are from Canada, but they both live in England now.
Q. Q. Bresk. Bresk. Somehow. Somehow. Capity. Capity. Era. Era. Swind. Swind. Boost. Boost. Linger. Linger. Implow. Implow.
Educational methods include teaching, storytelling, discussions, and research. Educational methods include teaching, storytelling, discussions, and research. Educational methods include teaching, storytelling, discussions, and research.
Many large university institutions are now starting to offer free online courses. Many large university institutions are now starting to offer free online courses. Many large university institutions are now starting to offer free online courses. Developments in technology and transportation infrastructure have made tourism more affordable. Developments in technology and transportation infrastructure have made tourism more affordable. Developments in technology and transportation infrastructure have made tourism more affordable.
De-stall. De-stall. Viable. Viable. Serial. Serial. Disand. Disand. Expayer. Expayer.
Ward. Ward. Enver. Enver. Manifest. Manifest. Trauma. Trauma.
Cultural globalization refers to the transmission of ideas, meanings, and values around the world. Cultural globalization refers to the transmission of ideas, meanings, and values around the world. Cultural globalization refers to the transmission of ideas, meanings, and values around the world.
It ended in a draw, but it was a good game because both teams played well.
The internet is down in my apartment, so I'm trying to fix it.
Factly. Felp. Hatic. Precision. Veteran. Spouse. Hawk. Invoke. Toxic. Resume. Resume. Vact. Vact. Tonkel. Tonkel. Outlet. Outlet. Nest. Nest. Plurt. Plurt. Outlook. Outlook. Resual. Resual. Ironic. Ironic.
One reason you might consider studying abroad is for the chance to experience different styles of education. One reason you might consider studying abroad is for the chance to experience different styles of education. One reason you might consider studying abroad is for the chance to experience different styles of education.
neither the teacher nor the students were in the classroom this morning.
Clask. Clask. Whinnied. Whinnied. Uphold. Uphold. Mixtry. Mixtry. Utterly. Utterly. Plaxy. Plaxy. Trace. Trace. Prector. Prector. Venture. Venture.
Actually, neither my dad nor my mum went to university. A book that I've read recently, which really inspired me, was called Surely You're Joking, Mr. Feynman, by the famous physicist Dr. Feynman. This book is a collection of personal stories from Dr. Feynman's life. The stories are both hilarious and thought-provoking. This book is mainly about all the life lessons that Dr. Feynman learned in his amazing life. For instance, do things that you love as best as you can. Each chapter covers one important part of his life, such as his time at university or the time he met Albert Einstein. Turning to the next question, the first time I heard of this book was on a podcast where two people were talking about the most influential books that they have ever read. Even though I hadn't heard of Dr. Feynman then, the way they talked about him was inspiring. I liked that this book was a biography, and I was able to learn about this fascinating man through his own stories. This image shows a man and a woman sitting next to each other on a bench in a park, and they look upset about something. There is a tall white building that looks like a church, which is in the background in the top right-hand corner. There are some people waiting outside that building. In front of that building, there is a narrow path which leads to another building on the left. That building is under construction. There is also a small park in front of the white building, which has several trees and a lot of autumn leaves covering the grass. The two young adults are sitting on a brown bench in the foreground of this image. The two people both look irritated and they are not talking to each other. The man is holding his forehead with both hands and staring down at the pavement, while the woman has her head in her right hand and looking in the opposite direction to the man. They might have just broken up with each other because their body language looks extremely tense. Many people believe that schools should be banned from serving fast food to their students. Do you agree or disagree? Provide reasons. Many people believe that schools should be banned from serving fast food to their students. Do you agree or disagree? Provide reasons. I agree that children should be banned from eating fast food at school for several important reasons. First, fast food is detrimental to children's health. For instance, fast food is often packed with fat, sugar, salt, and preservatives, which makes them extremely unhealthy for children. Also, if schools were banned from serving fast food, they would only be able to serve healthy food. This would surely be beneficial to students' health. In addition, schools should stop serving fast food because it is very expensive. It is a well-known fact that fresh food from a supermarket is significantly cheaper than pre-made fast food. So, for these reasons, I believe it is vital that schools stop serving fast food to their students.
Okay, that's the full test. How did you do? Let me know below in the comments. And if you want more practice, I recommend watching this video or this video next. Okay, have a wonderful day. See you.